Good morning, student. Welcome to the lecture series on strength of material. This is lecture number 1. This learning resource is basically meant for the student of second year diploma in mechanical engineering under Maharashtra State Board of Technical Education. Myself, Ashish Ragnarlande, lecturer at Department of Mechanical Engineering, KK Wagh Polytechnic, Nashik. In today's first lecture, we are going to focus on some of the basic concepts. We know that every strong building and every tall tree has a very strong base. Unlike if you want to learn the subject in a very best manner, to understand the basic concept, to apply the concept, to score well, there is a very much important of the basis. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about some of the basic definition, some of the basic laws, some of the basic definitions associated with the material properties. First definition is the mass. It is nothing but the amount of matter contained in the body. It is denoted by letter, generally small letter m, and the unit of mass in SI system is kg. Second one is weight. It is the gravitational pull or gravitational force exerted by the earth on the object. As it is a gravitational force exerted by the earth on an object, so the unit of weight is newton. It is given by the product of mass into acceleration due to gravity, and we know that the acceleration due to gravity varies from place to place, so weight varies from place to place, but mass remains throughout constant. It is the fundamental difference between mass and weight. Next important term is area. It is the most frequent term that occurs in our calculation. When we say the area of circle is pi by 4d square, area of rectangle is b into d, area of square is side square, what it exactly mean? It is nothing but amount of matter contained along two dimension. So it may be linear dimension, it may be lateral dimension. That means it is nothing, it will be the product of two dimensions of the length. So it will be given by, so its unit will be given by the product of two lengths. It is mm into mm, that is its unit will be mm square, either cm square or a meter square. So when we say pi by 4 d square, that means here d square, mm square, mm square, pi by 4 itself constant, so again unit balances. The same way b into d, b in x space is the mm, d into mm, so it will be mm square. Again side square, that is mm square. So you must always keep in mind that every term which we give, it should be dimensionally stable. The next important term is volume. Unlike an area, we can also define it as the amount of matter contained, but not in a two dimension but in a three dimension. In another way, the volume can be defined as the amount of matter contained in a three dimension. In another way, volume can be defined as the product of area into third dimension. So definitely its unit will be mm cube, cm cube or a meter cube. While dealing with the numericals of the strength of material, generally the dimensions are expressed in terms of in mm. So the unit of area for the calculation purpose is usually taken as mm square, and for the volume the unit is generally taken as mm cube. Next, the very important terms with the Newton's laws of motion. There are three basic laws. First one is the law of inertia. It states that every body continues state of rest in uniform motion unless it is acted upon by external force. Second law, it is law of conservation of momentum. It states that the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the in-place force, and it acts in the direction of in-place force. By the second law, the very important quantity which changes the state of an object, which we call as a force, is been given, and there is a very much importance of this quantity force in the study of strength of material. Third one, a very famous and very easy law, law of action and reaction. To every action, there is always equal and opposite reaction. So these three laws are the foundations are one of the important laws in the study of strength of material. Next important term is force. We had already discussed that the external agency which changes the state of an object is called as force, and it has been given from which law? Newton's second law of motion. It is the product of mass into acceleration due to gravity. So it will give that force is equal to m into a. Now, depending on the application, the force may be tensile. That means it is pull, compressive, it is push, and a shear. That means its nature may be, it may be act in a parallel or a perpendicular direction. What will be the unit of the force? The unit of mass is kg, and the unit of acceleration due to gravity is meter per second square. So it is called as meter. It is one of the basic fundamental terms which is very frequently occurred in the study of strength of material. Next term is the sum of the basic mechanical properties. What are the basic mechanical properties? Elasticity, plasticity, ductility, malleability, hardness, toughness, brittleness, fatigue, and creep. Today we are going to focus on the only four basic mechanical properties. Remaining property in a subsequent lecture we are going to focus. Elasticity. Let us take rubber and up and pull it. What you can to know that there is a change in its dimension occur. Now, if you remove the force, it will regain its original shape. I said, now it is the property. It is that property. It is called as elasticity. How elasticity can be defined? It is defined as the ability of a material to regain its original shape and size when force is removed. Second one is plasticity. It is also called as partial elasticity. That means it can be also defined as the ability of a material do not regain completely its original shape and size when force is removed. That means this word do not regain completely states that there will be deformation. This deformation, plastic deformation. The elasticity, there is also deformation, but that deformation get vanishes. That's why the particular material when we stretch came into its original shape and size when we remove the applied force. Next one is the ductility and malleability. Basically, these two quantities give the idea about the how we can stretch the material, whether we are able to make it into thin wires or thin sheets. So the ductility is nothing but the ability of a material to be drawn into thin wires, while malleability is also defined as the ability of a material to be drawn into thin sheets. A material which behaves ductility, it is called as ductile material, while the material which behaves which has the property of malleability are called malleable material. Next important basic term is stress. What is stress? It is defined as a resistive force upon area. Let us consider the block as shown in the figure. It is acted with a force P, a tensile force P. We know that when force is applied, as per Newton's third law, there is always equal and opposite reaction. That means there is always resistance. Now, if we took the ratio of that resistive force to the area over which it is the force is acted, then that quantity will be known as stress. So stress is defined as a resistive force upon cross-sectional area. It is denoted by letter sigma. So sigma is given by P by A, where P stands for applied load, which is exactly equal to the resistive force, and A stands for the cross-sectional area over which the force is supposed to be acted. Now, in a broad sense, when we think about stress, what we came to know that it is the intensity of a force which acted over a given section. Now, let's talk about unit. What will be its unit? It will be as the unit of force is Newton and the unit of area is meter square. So the unit of stress is Newton per meter square, that it is called Pascal. But it is small unit. For a larger case, the units are kilopascal, megapascal, and gigapascal. This term K, M, and G. K stands for 10 to the power 3. M stands for 10 to the power 6. And G stands for 10 to the power 9. So when we talk about 10 kilopascal, it will be equal to 10 to the power 3 Newton per mm, Newton per meter square. When megapascal is equal to 10 to the power 6 Newton per meter square. In a strength of metal, as I talked before, that the generally dimensions are given in mm, the unit of area is mm squared. So the term MPa in order to denote all these stresses is going to be used. So MPa is also equal to 1 MPa is equal to 1 Newton per mm squared. The same way, 1 GPa is equal to 10 to the power 3 Newton per mm squared or 10 to the power 9 Newton per meter squared. Usually, stress is expressed in terms of MPa and the elastic constant like E, G, and K are expressed in GPa. Now, let's another basic term is strain. Before discussing the strain, it is very important to discuss about the deformation. So, what is basically a concept of deformation? It is nothing but change in dimension. Now, when we apply the force, the change in dimension may be along the length. We can say it is a linear deformation. Or it may be other than length in other dimensions. It is called a lateral deformation. Now, if we took the ratio of these two quantities, the change in dimension to the original dimension, what we call that quantity? So, that quantity is nothing but the strain. So, how strain can be defined? It can be defined as the ratio of change in dimension to the original dimension. And it is generally denoted by letter small e. As it is a ratio of two similar quantity, change in dimension to the original dimension, that means change in length to the original length, so it has a no unit. So, in today's lecture, what we have discussed some of the basic concepts associated with the subject, unlike mass, weight, area, volume. Next, we have started the discussion with the Newton's laws of inertia. We have discussed that it is the Newton's second law. We give the idea of the very basic quantity, very difficult quantity used in the study of strength of material, that is force. Then we have discussed about the quantity, the force. External agency, which change the state of an object. And also discussed its type and its suite. The type are basic types are tensor, compress, and shear, the based on your application. Next, we have discussed about the basic mechanical property. We have discussed about the elasticity, plasticity, ductility, and mobility. We also discussed about two basic terms, stress and strain. In the coming up of lectures, we are going to discuss about the types of stress, type of strain, elastic constant, the basic mechanical properties. Till then, enjoy. Thank you.